Okay, the next question that was asked was number 43 from R1. And 43 asked us to find A and B so that if F was continuous, if we plug in those numbers. So if a function's continuous, it shouldn't have any breaks in it. It should all connect. And so we have three separate pieces in this piecewise function, and we want this, wherever this one stops, we want this one to start at that same y value. And so what we'll need to do is set these two equal to each other. And you need to look at what x they meet at, and they meet at negative 1. So when x is equal to negative 1, we want the first function to equal the second function. So that means we want negative 1 to equal ax squared plus bx. And we are going to plug in this actual value of x here, because we want them to equal when x is negative 1. So I'll have negative 1 equals a times negative 1 squared plus b times negative 1. Simplifying, I'm going to get a minus b. And that is one equation. I will use that equation. I can't solve it anymore, so I'm going to save that to be able to use that in a minute. There's another place we want to for them to connect, and that is between the middle function and the lower function. We want those to be equal, and they meet at the x value of 1. So when x is 1, we want this middle equation to equal the lower equation. We want the y value that I get from 1 here to be the same as the y value that I get from 1 there. So we're going to put 1 in every x spot and see if they equal each other. So here I would have a times 1 squared plus b times 1, 3 times 1 minus 1. So this comes out a plus b equals 3 minus 1 or 2. Now I have two equations, and I want to put those together so that I can solve and see what a and b are. So right here I'm going to copy this one over. I have a minus b equals negative 1, and when I add those two equations, I will get 2a, b's will cancel, equals 1, and by dividing I'll know that a is a half. Then I can plug that back in over here or over here, either one. Kind of like this one, a plus b equals 2. If I put this half in and subtract, I'll find that b equals 1.5 or 3/2. And those should be the y values, so that if I put those into that function, they would all meet. We don't need to worry about the slope that they're meeting at, because it doesn't ask to make it differentiable, just continuous. So continuous just means that one piece connects to the next piece, and the next piece connects to the third piece. And so what we've done is made each of them connect. So the right answer is a equals half, b equals 3/2.